This will be the final regular season meeting between these teams, the Ducks and the Blackhawks. Last time out, the Ducks won 3-2, so the series even at one apiece.
Montour switches sides with Fowler, keeping it in, and Raquel on the half wall on the right side of the zone. Raquel brings it into the middle, right at the side of the net, gets off back for Raquel, he scores! Nice looking play, and a power play goal gives Anaheim the lead.
Watch how Rickard Rakell and Ryan Getzlaf turn it into a two-on-one with Brent Seabrook defending. So Rakell gives it up. It's a little give and go. Getzlaf delivers a perfect strike back to him, and the Ducks' hottest goal scorer strikes again from tight quarters.
Saad comes up with it. Feeds the point. Jordan Osterley had a goal yesterday against the Kings. Didn't get it to the net. Kane got the rebound. Looking for Taves in front. He got tangled up with Fowler. A whistle. The puck covered as everybody is in the blue paint.
Boy, John Gibson somehow manages to come up with a stop here. It's a scrambly play. And John Gibson does an outstanding job. He keeps that glove hand over top of the pad and just gets enough of the puck.
Little helter-skelter in the defensive zone. Now Getzlaf puts his head down as he finds some room through center. Gets it to Perry into the zone. Perry spins in front. Score! What a goal! Corey Perry makes it 2-0.
Look at this little spinorama here. Osterley doesn't lay a glove on him. He brings the puck dead in front of the net. Nobody touches him. And he's got Forsberg at his mercy. And you can't let Corey Perry walk into the slot like that untouched.
Camp can't find a passing lane, has it broken up. Camp and Sharp right back in. Here's Highmore. The rookie circles the net, tries to wrap around. Gibson reached out, somehow got the right pad on it. Murphy didn't get much on his bid. Boy, Highmore looked like he had his first NHL goal. There was a lot of net there. And Gibson able to rescue it. Pass off of Kane, jumping over the boards as Richie, who receives the puck, brings it in, pulls it in. Forsberg gave up a rebound. A couple of bids, one by Silverberg and a second by Richie. Both kept out.
And again, you're just allowed to go to that crease in front of the Hawks net and nobody lays a hand on you.
The Henrique line out as Schmaltz makes a move into the middle of the ice, hands it off on the wing, and it's a left pad save by Gibson. DeBrincat knocks it out of midair, and a blocker save by Gibson.
That's a great sequence for John Gibson. The puck pops up in the air, and chopping it right out of the air was DeBrincat. Get your body in the right spot, because almost impossible to react that quickly from a batted puck from close range.
Bieksa gets it to the net, and Pettersson gets his first NHL goal, floating it through traffic. It started with Bieksa with a heavy shot from the right point, and Forsberg served the rebound all the way out, and Marcus Pettersson in his eighth NHL game has his first.
Watch the traffic in front. It's Derek Grant that is going to set a high screen here. When the puck comes back to Pettersson, it's both Chimera and Grant, as Pettersson just feeds it through. Almost looked like that may have hit something.
Lindholm carries the mail. Cogliano's shot blocker to side. As Forsberg got a piece of it, Grant shovels it back. Cogliano centers. It comes to Silverberg, and he scores! Jakob Silverberg with just his second goal in 15 games. Anaheim on top, 4-0.
I mentioned how impressed I was with the game by Silverberg last game. Didn't get any rewards for the effort. And Derek Grant again does a good job of keeping that puck alive so that Silverberg can settle it, measure the goaltender, and he just drills it up into the top corner.
The Ducks go on the power play, Brian, against a new goaltender, Jean-Francois Berube.
Yeah, he takes over for Forsberg.
Hawks trying to change while they work in the offensive zone. They do well to do it. Here's Kane. Save Gibson, and the rebound swept out of harm's way.
Spectacular stop by Gibson. Kane had a passing option there. Tried to throw it up top under the bar, and Gibson was waiting for him.
Rockets it down low. Taves feeds it back now. This is Duncan Keith. Duclair gives it to Keith. One time blast by Murphy. Scores!
Well, it almost seemed inevitable. I think it's Thomas Yurko that gets a touch on this puck, but the Blackhawks keep getting grade A scoring opportunities. There's the redirect. Judging by the reaction of Yats, Yurko, there's no chance whatsoever by Gibson.
Duclair denied entry at the blue line, comes back out, and now carries in. Anthony Duclair feeds it over. That shot by Osterley, I believe Gibson got a piece of.
This one, as he comes diving across, takes it right off the melon. Brian Getzlaf when he passes the puck, because he can just move it around and move that puck in so many different directions.
Here's Schmaltz. Can he get around Manson? He does, and he scores. Nick Schmaltz, and more life for the Hawks.
Schmaltz is battling here with Josh Manson, and Manson is trying to make sure that he can't get back to the inside. So he's pushing him outside, but Gibson stays deep in his crease. And somehow that puck seems to go right through the Anaheim goaltender, right through the wickets.
Pass through the middle, broken up by Kessler. He'll get to it in the Chicago zone in front for Cogliano. Little redirect, and Berube loses it, and they score!
I think it's Silverberg.
Silverberg came in, lost his stick, but he'll get credit for the goal.
It'll be interesting to see how this puck gets in behind the goaltender Berube. The referees are already convening over near the penalty box. Ducks are hoping it's Silverberg's second of the game.
Chicago is going to use their coach challenge to determine if there was goaltender interference on the play.
I don't think he's going to win this one.
I don't either, but I think some of this is, hey, we're down potentially three with 13 minutes to go. I got to try to take this one off the board.
After review, the call on the ice stands. It's a good goal.
Getzlaf gets it back, feeds the point. It's Fowler, walks it to the middle. Back to the captain. Getzlaf to Fowler, walks right in. Score! Corey Perry got his own rebound. Second of the game for Perry. Ducks up four again.
Look at Getzlaf. Gives it back to Fowler, gets it back. It's a little give and go again. This time Fowler to Perry. Berube actually makes a great stop on the first hit by Corey Perry, but with his body out of control, he has no chance.
And Estroza's pass hit Mikkel. Now he gets it in, and Gibson calmly plays it behind the net. Turned over, and Schmaltz scores. Manson was tripped behind the net as he reversed that puck away, and it took him a split second to get back into the play as Anaheim turned the puck over.
Yeah, mishandle of the puck in behind. The big defensive responsibility in this game fell on the shoulders of Kessler, Silverberg, and Cogliano, who did a magnificent job with the Hawks' big line of Sontaves and Kane.
The Anaheim Ducks, six. The Chicago Blackhawks, three. The Ducks move into sole possession, a third in the Pacific Division with the victory.